two here. Allen to throw, and this ball is... Oh, what a tremendous catch by the tight end, Bob Gitchum. Bob Gitchum, a great, great one-handed catch, and a Viking first down. Wow.
I am Bob Gitchum, and I currently live in Folsom, California. I suck at all three disciplines, you know, terrible swimmer. I'm an okay biker, and running, I just can't run. I'm too big, you know, 270 pounds, so trying to run just sucks. I'm thinking this when I'm, you know, 10 years old. Like, there's no way I'd ever do one of those things. It's just stupid. Like, why would you put yourself through that? And then fast forward, you know, 30, 40 years, and my buddy was into doing these things, and he hit me up, and he's like, hey, man, I'm going to go do a half Ironman in Hawaii. Why don't you come join me? And I saw all shapes and sizes of people out there doing it. I mean, if there's a guy out there or a lady out there with one leg doing this, I'm an able-bodied human being, so I should be able to do it, was my thought. I'm like, well, that guy can do it, or that girl can do it. I can do it. So I signed up and did Santa Rosa the following year. I found out about the Legacy program. So you gotta do 12, right? So I'm like, well, that's a good goal. So I spoke to my wife and said, hey, I wanna go do this Kona race. I go, I know it was crazy the past year of me training to do Hawaii and doing Santa Rosa, and it's gonna be like this. I go, I'm gonna get it done in 5 years, was my plan. So I was cruising along, you know, doing a couple events a year, and my daughter had a volleyball tournament in Santa Cruz. We were just cruising along, and next thing you know, I'm just driving, and I kind of just glance over to my left, and I see two headlights coming right at me. That was it. That's all I remember. What was that? And we got, you know, smoked, going probably 80 miles an hour. I had no idea, you know, what happened, who I was with, where I was, and they said, your daughter's fine. I'm like, what do you mean my daughter? And then it came back to me like, holy crap. And then I looked at my foot, and my foot's in a halo thing up here and down in my, around my foot. And, you know, they told me the extent of, you know, my injuries, you know, from the impact of the crash. It detached my intestines. So that's why they had to cut me open and, you know, reattach them and put them back together. I broke three vertebrae in my back, a broken rib, which really hurt when you breathe or cough. And the worst injury of it all, I think, was I broke my my calcaneus bone, which is your heel bone. So that's probably one of the worst bones in your body you can break. I had an Ironman Cozumel bag in my truck, and they must have grabbed it and brought it to the hospital. So they're like, oh, he probably does Ironman, you know? So somebody, I still haven't found out to this day who did it, but somebody printed a MDOT, just a black and white photo of an MDOT, and put it on my cabinet. But when I saw that MDOT and realized what happened to me, I was like, oh my God, I gotta get back to doing what I love doing and, you know, finish my goal I made of, you know, completing 12 of these things and going to Kona. I just was obsessed and still am. But I always hoped if I was ever put in a situation like this that I would be strong and get back to being me. And I'm back to being me, and I think I'm a little better for this accident. You know, that old adage that what doesn't kill you makes you stronger. So true, just so true. That bond between my daughter and I going through that, yeah, it's definitely brought us closer, I think. Blessing in disguise. You know, you just gotta take the positives out of whatever life throws at you. So that's kind of what I do. You just gotta, you know, find the silver. There's always a silver lining. At least I think there is, or I try to find it. So that's what we do.